After Sam died, my mom and Edie got really close. They'd both lost a lot. I can't imagine my mom ever writing poetry, and yet...
A poem for Gus, who always said the wedding was a bad idea. Our father never hit us kids, at least not very hard, before the day my brother said with teenage disregard that he'd be dead before he'd see a wedding in our yard. Father made him come, of course, but Gus stood far apart, just flew his kite and bottled up the storm inside his heart. I tried to talk him out of it, but though he'd never met her, we don't need a stepmom, were the words that I
now pronounce you husband and wife. Make him cry.
When the time for photos came, Dad ordered him to
come here.
But Gus declined, and as a sign, held up his middle finger. The wind picked up, and panicked geese appeared and quickly went. But all the humans did that day was go inside the tent. Rain came down in buckets then, but no one seemed afraid that nature might destroy the tent our dad had crudely made. The thunder sounded much too close and full of angry power, but all my father said to this was, "Make the music louder." I wish that I could truly say I thought about you on that day. Out there on the beach alone, just you, the wind, the sea, and foam. But I didn't. Until we found you.
She never talked about him, but Mom told me once if I was a boy, they were going to name me Gus.
Dear Kay, do you remember the way Gregory used to laugh when he thought he was alone? Like something funny was happening, but only he could see it. I think he saw things the rest of us don't.
Hold on, sweetie.
Hello? Sam, I told you I don't want to talk right now.
I wonder what he saw. What his world was like. Imagination. Whatever it was, he saw. It sure made him happy.
I don't want Gregory to hear this.
I wish he could have told us about the world he saw. There's so much I don't understand. Sam.